In 1772, Moravian missionary David Zeisberger established the Delaware Indian village of Schönbrunn. Because of its success, he founded a second village, called Gnadenhutten, the same year. Located in Tuscarawas County, Gnadenhutten was a peaceful village for Delaware Indian converts of Christianity. Though they remained neutral during the American Revolution, they were distrusted by both the Americans and the British. In 1781, the British ordered all the Delaware to abandon their villages in Ohio and to relocate along the Sandusky River. Because they arrived at their new villages too late in the fall to plant, food shortages became a reality over the winter. In March of the following year, Zeisberger sent a group of Delaware back to Gnadenhutten to harvest what crops remained in the fields. While there, a group of Pennsylvania militiamen attacked them, mistakenly believing that these Delaware were responsible for recent raids in nearby Pennsylvania. The Native Americans were rounded up by the militiamen and were told they would be executed the following morning. During the night, the Indians sang hymns and prayed. When morning came, the Delaware men were taken in pairs inside a cabin where they were stunned with mallet blows to the head, then killed by scalping. The same fate took place with the women and children inside a second cabin. However, two boys were able to escape, despite the fact that one had been scalped. They were able to share the tragic events, which became known as the Gnadenhutten Massacre. You can visit the site today and see some of the reconstructed buildings, as all the originals had been burned by the militiamen. You can also see the mass grave of the Indians, where 28 men, 29 women, and 39 children were buried. 100 years later, in 1872, a monument was erected and still stands today in memory of those who were murdered. There's also a museum you can visit. Inside, you'll find more information on the work of Zeisberger, as well as the Gnadenhutten village and the Christian Delaware who live there. While Gnadenhutten is largely remembered for the massacre that occurred, there's one more interesting piece of history that you'll discover. This was also the location of the first white child born in the area that would become the Buckeye State. So the next time you're ready to hit the road and go traveling around Ohio, consider heading to Gnadenhutten and learning more about the Gnadenhutten Massacre.